Over the past year and a half, a simple stroll in the woods became a non-stop quest to find out more about one of the UK's most secretive mammals, the badger. With the help of several camera traps, I've been learning more about these fossorial mustelids, observing their social behaviours, marvelling at the way badger cubs interact with the world around them, and realising that badgers aren't as nocturnal as I'd initially thought.
But I'm not the only one who's got a little bit of a thing for badgers. Wildlife photographer Rachel Bigsby has been spending the majority of her free time getting to know her local badger clan, and in true National Badger Day spirit, I've come along to have a good old natter and to hopefully catch a glimpse of her badgers. So what is it about watching badgers that excites you so much?
For me, it's got to be their secrecy. Before I found this set, I spent years trying and failing to see a badger. And each evening when the first badger emerges from their secret underground homes, it's just as exciting as the first time. So how have badgers made an impression on you?
Well, badgers have actually been a part of my life for as long as I can remember, really. I went to school in a town called Broxbourne, and Broxbourne, the word itself, is derived from two Old English words, the first being brock for badger and the second burner for stream. So I quite literally went to school in a badger stream. Yeah. And it was the logo of our school, and you know, I saw a picture of a badger on a bin every morning walking to school. But I didn't actually see a live one until I was 18 at university, and it wasn't until last year that I started seeing them regularly, and this fixation and obsession with badgers actually really took hold. Now, with the badger group that you've been watching over the last couple of years, have you sort of noticed any characters, any individuals that sort of stand out more than the others?
Absolutely. So there's approximately 15 badgers in this clan, so they are really difficult to identify as individuals. Mm. But this year's cub always stands out. It's the first to emerge each evening. It's really eager to explore. And if it catches a scent of something it fancies for dinner, it's often the badger that will clamber over all of the logs and family members to get to it. So what do you normally observe within the first sort of 10 minutes of your badgers?
So I've been watching two badger families when they first emerge out of their sets in the evening. You know, there'll be a lot of like self-grooming, scratching their groins and their bellies, doing that sort of characteristic, like almost like DJ mixing on their tummies. But that would soon turn into sort of a social activity, and they'll be all around each other, helping each other reach those spots on their back that they can't get, which is known as allo-grooming. That's something that I see quite early on into the evening, but I think my favourite behaviour that I've observed on my camera traps, now this is going to make me sound like a bit of a weirdo, is bum pressing.
Yeah.
Now, the first time I watched it, I was completely like bamboozled about what was going on. I was like, why on earth are they putting their bums together? So obviously I looked into it, and it plays a vital role in badger communication. Now, they have a scent gland in between their bum and their tail, which they then press onto one another. And it's so that the badger group shares a common odour, so it's that clan has a distinctive signature smell. Yeah. But one thing I think that we should acknowledge here is that sadly, the 2021 badger cull has already started, and that over the next 5 years, a further 140,000 badgers are going to be killed. Now, where we are today, we're quite lucky that this is in a safe zone. No cull licences have been issued here, which is great. But it's a very different story where I'm currently living in Gloucestershire, and I know full well that I'm going to be devastated if anything happens to my badger families, and I'm sure you'd feel the same.
Absolutely. I mean, it doesn't bear thinking about, does it? Badgers are so wise and fascinating and true living symbols of our British countryside, yet they are just wrongly persecuted and victimised for crimes that they didn't commit. And the idea of any pain being inflicted on any badger and their lives so wrongly taken, it just breaks my heart. But on a positive note, if you could sum up your time with badgers in three words, what would they be?
So watching badgers has definitely sort of been my light through the doom and gloom of the past 18 months or so. So I think it's definitely going to have to be my happy place. It sounds a bit corny, but watching badgers over the last 18 months has definitely kept me motivated. It's kept me in tune with the natural world, and yes, it's kept me happy.
As daytime turned to dusk, Billy and I sat down with our binoculars and waited for the badger family to emerge. And with us tucked away, out of view, it didn't take long for them to make an appearance. The earliest traces of badgers in Britain date back to 500,000 years ago, meaning that badgers once coexisted with brown bears, Arctic foxes, and wolves that once roamed Britain. Now it is our time to coexist with badgers, and our duty to ensure they roam Britain for 500,000 years more.